Hi. Okay, so today we're going to talk about probably one of the most commonly asked questions in CCTV. And what is that question? What is the difference between IP, PoE, and Bnc Analogue? And it is a very good question, and I'll hopefully be able to tell you in those couple of minutes. So let me quickly show you the difference between the two cameras. Okay, so these are both Hikvision cameras, and they're both actually colour view cameras, some of the latest cameras here. Alright, and this is an IP camera. As you see, it uses a connection much like you use for your internet. Okay, RJ45 LAN cable. And this is just an extra power jack just in case you want to test the camera quickly or you don't have a PoE NVR. That's for another day, but just don't worry about this part. This is the main part here. So you get your power and your data run through this one connector right here. Very good. Alright, and we have a Bnc camera here. Okay, so this is a 4-in-1 switch. Don't worry about that for now. And we have here our Bnc connector. And we have our power jack as well. Now, the power jack you will need for these, unlike the PoE camera. But they run a different... These ones, you can twist in the Bnc adapter into the cable. And that's the physical differences of them. So, in reality, what is the main differences? And what is the benefits over one or the other? Okay then, so the main difference when you're installing a system is that with a Bnc system, all the cables, they must run to the back of the DVR. So they have to be physically connected via an analog Bnc cable to the DVR. There's no other way around it, okay? So they usually you can go up to 100 meters, roughly, depending on your power supply. The further the distance is, obviously, the more power you're going to need. But they are very reliable, and nowadays you can use CAT cable, you can use coaxial cable. There's many different ways to wire up an analog system. But like I said, the main disadvantage is that it has to be all wired to the back of the DVR. But for a normal home system, this is perfectly fine, perfectly normal. And let me show you an IP camera, how to wire up an IP camera is different. All right, so you can traditionally use your IP camera just like an analog camera and wire it to the back of your NVR and use the PoE to power it, and just one thin cable does your job. No problem with that. But the one massive advantage to an IP camera is that, well, the first advantage is you don't even need a recorder. You could have it standalone and record onto the SD card, straight onto the camera. As you see here, you put in your SD card, boom, you don't even need a recorder. Okay, or you can have that recording just as backup, just in case something happens to your recorder. But the beauty of an IP PoE system, and this is why you usually pay at least double or triple for one, as opposed to an analog system for the same type of quality system, it is because you don't have to have the cameras connected to the back of the NVR. Okay, what you can do is you can connect switches or ports or have access ports around your business or home where you can plug the cameras into. So this makes installation and running cables really a lot easier, especially if you have a massive big warehouse or multi-story building and you want everything to be on one central recorder, then IP is the way to go because you can use your access points to wire up everything and then go through your software and your NVR can link everything together. So that's one massive advantage. Okay, a couple of little points is with a analog camera, even though they are very good nowadays, the picture quality does start to deteriorate slightly over time. Okay, there's not a lot you could do about it. It's just the way things are. I mean, no lens is perfect, obviously, with the IP, but because it is digital, it does use zeros and ones for the picture, you're always going to get a perfect picture. Okay. It is just the way it is. Coaxial cameras, you know, obviously there's magnetic interference, there's all kinds of different interferences and things like that. But with IP, it's digital. So always going to get a good picture. All right. So I think that covers the main differences between analog and IP. As you can see also, the IP camera is, they are generally bigger cameras and heavier. So some people like that. I prefer nice small cameras. A lot neater, a lot easier to install, but that's your personal choice there. So, like I said, I would recommend PoE if you can afford it, 100% PoE all day. Or if you have a big business with multiple access points and you want a nice, neat job, PoE is the way to go. But if you're running new cable and you're happy to run cable to the back of your DVR, obviously we would choose cat cable because you can obviously decide to go IP in the future. We recommend you go for analogue. So analogue for most home systems is more than good enough and it's going to do you a really good job and last you at least a few years of system. So I hope you learned something today, guys, and what the difference between the main two types of CCTV systems are. And if you're interested in one, just go to our website, ssrtrading.co.uk, and find our details, give us a call, and we'll be happy to sell you one. All right. Cheers. Thank you. Bye.